What's up, content creators? I'm going to show you exactly how to set up the Reincubate Camo application with OBS Studio so that you can unlock some seriously cool capabilities for your recording, for streaming, for using your phone as a web camera. Let's dig right in. Stick around for the end because I'm going to blow your mind with a comparison between a Panasonic GH5 and an iPhone 11 Pro Max using the Reincubate Camo app. All right, so the first thing that you're gonna do is install the OBS Open Broadcaster software, which is totally free to install. You can go to obsproject.com and download it for your computer, totally free. Next, we're gonna go to reincubate.com and you're going to click on this button here for Camo, and it will automatically detect which computer you have. So get that installed. And then open up the OBS software. Now yours might look a little bit different. I've got these extra panels for the Restream application. So the panel you're looking for inside of OBS is this window here, labeled Sources. We're gonna go ahead and click on the plus symbol, go to Video Capture Device, and we're gonna call this Camo, just to make it easy to remember it. Click OK, and in this dropdown, select Camo, and you should see it here. So your device should show up, so you don't really have to change any of this stuff. I wouldn't recommend necessarily digging into this. I'm just gonna leave it the way it is. Click on OK, and if your window is not correctly sized to the canvas, this is the canvas area. This is your output for your stream or your recording of your content. You're just gonna go ahead and grab these. You can move this around however you want, and you're gonna resize this. Now, the other part to this is you can control the Camo application with the desktop app for Mac or Windows. Check this out. I've got the pro version here. If you don't have that, there is a 15% off coupon code in the description below this video. I definitely recommend pro. For the investment, what you get out of it, you don't have any of these controls unlocked with the free version. There's a number of things you can't do without the pro, but I love having the pro version because you can control your white balance temperature manually. You can set the shutter speed to lock it in. You can control tint. All of these controls are unlocked. And then one of my favorite things actually for using Camo with OBS is this feature here. So we can zoom this in and we can reposition our frame. And if we go back to OBS here, you could see, oh, okay, maybe that's not working exactly the way I want. And so I can actually go back here and change the zoom and completely customize the frame. The other thing you can do is you can change the resolution with the pro version. I'm using 1080p. I actually really like it. I think it looks great. Check this out now. Okay, so if I set this up, I'll just frame this the way I want it. Trying to set up the lines in the studio here, and that looks pretty good there. So go back to OBS, and that looks good. So we'll just leave it like this. Keep in mind, you can add your microphones in here if you want to be recording audio, and you can do all kinds of awesome stuff with this. So down here, just a quick reference, if you haven't seen any of my other tutorials with OBS in it, you can start a recording here. Now, one thing you could do with your mobile device and a second camera is you could set up two camera angles at your desk with your phone as your primary or secondary, and then the other camera or mobile device as a second angle with a 30 to 40 degree difference so that you've got that second camera angle and you're able to switch between those two sources. If you have a setup like this, you can transform this setup into a top-down shot right at your computer, enabling you to capture things like a whiteboard. So you could use the Camo application in conjunction with a number of applications so that you can actually create better content for your YouTube channel, your social media, whatever you're doing, even your courses online. Let me know how you're planning on using the Camo Studio and OBS application to record content so that I can come up with more content for you. All right, let me show you the comparison between the GH5 and the Camo application with an iPhone. So I'll turn the Camo on first. This is the iPhone 12 Pro Max, and we're gonna switch over to the GH5. Look at that. The difference is pretty staggering, isn't it? Don't you think that the iPhone actually looks incredible? Now, it depends on what phone you have. Let me know if you like this video by smashing that thumbs up button. It helps it perform better, and I truly appreciate it. If you want to learn more about the Camo application, I have a playlist of videos for you right up here. To make Camo application with an iPhone 11 Pro Max? Is it a 12? I don't even know what phone I have. Is it 11 or a 12? It's a Pro Max. It's got three lenses. How do we even know anymore? And I'm going to be releasing all kinds of awesome content for you guys this year. Super stoked about the new channel. Oh my God, what am I doing?